messages here. I said, Lord, these people are not even in this place. See, let me tell y'all. When you come into the house of God, come here to worship. Come here to praise Him. Come here to lift Him up. Because the more that you do that, the Bible says God inhabits the praises of His people. See, God loves to hear your sweet praise. Come on, somebody. Then it make Him want to get off of His throne and come and present Himself down in the midst of the congregation, which is known as the presence of God. Amen. It's in our midst. Amen.
Amen.
Lord have mercy. Jesus. Amen. I was going to preach this other one. I said, they're not ready for that one. Amen. Let me get this other one. Amen. Turn with me to the book of Luke. We always say, see, people, let me tell you something. If you don't have, listen to me good, the Holy Ghost down on the inside, which is the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Look at this here. Don't grow. Lord have mercy. God is so good to His people. Amen. I tell you. Hallelujah. God is good. I was babysitting last night. Twins babies. Amen. Taking care of them last night. Doing this and everything. That prime visual, I got up and I talked. Let somebody better say amen. Talk about Jesus. Don't be ashamed of the gospel of Christ. But it's the power of God unto salvation. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let me get over here right quickly. Amen. Go with me to the book of Luke. Amen. But while you're going to Luke, the first chapter, bow your heads. Father God, I thank you for the awesome presence of God that I feel in this place, Lord God. God, I ask you to move by your spirit, Lord God. Break every shackle, Lord God. Loose the bands of wickedness, Lord God. Set the captives free, Lord God. Lord, break every yoke. And Lord, in other words, destroy every yoke, God. In the name of Jesus. Those that keep your people bound, Lord
yes,
God. I ask you to break it. Destroy it. Eliminate it. Disintegrate it, God. In the name of Jesus. And I give you all the honor, the glory, and the praise. Let this word find a place in our hearts that we may not sin against you, that we'll get more and more and be like you, Father. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
We know that Jesus is the season, is the reason for the season. Amen.
Amen.
Even this season means Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
He is that reason for this season. Somebody better say amen.
Amen.
It's not about your gifts. Come on, somebody. Amen. Even though God bless us with different things. But you know what? I used to hear my mom say, every time around this time, amen, for Christmas, she always said, you know what? All I want is some more Jesus. This is what she tells us, her children. You know what? Glory to God. Go with me to the 12th chapter. I mean the first verse. And the first chapter, the 12th verse. I'm going to try to get through this a little bit so you can get to know about the Spirit of God and the birth of Jesus Christ and why the two twin towers came forth. It was John and Jesus. Come on, somebody. John came preparing the way. And the first thing that John did, I'm not going to get ahead of myself. Go with me now, because Lord, I can tear this thing up. Glory to the name Jesus. And if you got the scripture, stay with me. It's kind of in here.
Amen.
That's that Holy Ghost fire.
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Did y'all hear what I said?
Yeah.
Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's go to the 12th verse. Lord, y'all got to get with this thing. Listen. Let's read together. And when Zechariah saw him, he was troubled, and fear fell upon him. You know why Zechariah was troubled when he saw the angel? Because when you live for God and you know who God is, you don't have nothing but respect for who God is.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Read, y'all.
But the angel said unto him, fear not, Zechariah. For thy prayer is heard.
Uh-huh.
And thy wife Elizabeth shall
live. Something that Zechariah was praying about. Come Come on, somebody. And see, the Bible says this. He that cometh to God must believe that he is a rewarder of those that diligently seek him. Somebody better say amen. Amen. If you seek God for anything that you need, God will provide. Somebody better say amen. Amen. Seek him for healing. Seek him for wisdom. Seek him for knowledge. Seek God, and God will reward thee openly. Amen. Continue to read that. Read. Listen to what the angel said to Zacharias, a priest in the temple, serving in the temple of God day by day. Read on. Listen to what he said. And thou shalt have joy and gladness. And what else?
Many shall rejoice
at his birth. Even the forerunner of Christ, men are going to rejoice at John's birth because something is coming. Lord of mercy. Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Read on, y'all.
For he shall be great in the sight of the Lord.
Uh-huh.
And shall drink neither wine nor strong.
Y'all better watch yourself. You want to be you? Lord have mercy. This Christmas, y'all talk all the spirit. Come on, somebody. Y'all, Lord, have mercy. Lord, I just saw something. Yes, Lord. Even that little bit of nibble that you want to get. Come on, somebody. Amen. If you want God to use you. Lord, have mercy. I ain't going to tell you who this person was. Amen. The person said, you know what? I went by this store, and I tried, and I opened the door. And the door was closed, and I said, oh God. He went by the ABC store, but that's just a joke. Amen. I said, come on, Holy Ghost, teach us to walk in thy ways. Amen. How many of us have done that? Come on, somebody. He said he would come neither wine he shall not drink, neither wine, not strong drink. Not that 40. Come on, somebody. Lord, have mercy.
40.
Lord, y'all. Look, Jack Daniel got to go back where he came from. Come on, somebody. Somebody said, well, I can just get a little bit of the Muskogee, you know. Come on, somebody. You want God to use you. Let's be dedicated and committed unto the Lord. Amen. I see some of you right now. Somebody said, I had a beer last night. Oh. Come on, somebody.
You better breathe.
God sees, that's an all-seeing eye watching you. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And listen, read on, y'all. Lord have mercy. This is good stuff here.
He shall be filled with the Holy Ghost.
Listen at what he. John. Glory to God. And he shall be filled with the Holy Ghost. Read on.
Even from his mother's womb.
See, John was filled with the Holy Ghost. Even from his mother's womb. Somebody said, well, when did he get filled? We're going to go to that in just a few minutes. Amen.
Amen.
Now read that seven. Go ahead. Read the other verses. Go ahead. That's what we need. In order for people to be turned to God, we need to be filled with the Holy Ghost. Somebody better say amen. Even this was John, but Jesus, when he came, Jesus was filled with the Spirit of God as well. Amen. Read on.
And he shall go before
him,
the Spirit and
come on.
And
Lord, how many disobedient people we got in the church houses today? Lord, have mercy. Disobedient children, hard-headed, stiff-necked, don't want to do what the Lord said to do. Come on, somebody. We want to do what we want to do. But you being disobedient is not going to get you anywhere. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Disobedient to the some of the what? Just. Lord have mercy. The Bible said that just shall live by faith. The faith is that you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and believe that the word say this is this. That word right here. It's the hearing of the word of God is how we become cleansed and washed to the hearing of God's word. Amen. 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 Read on.
To make ready a people prepared for the Lord.
To make ready a people prepared for the Lord. Let's stop right there. Now listen to me. Amen. And I'm going to have you to read another part. Amen. Here it is that an angel came to Zacharias. And y'all can read that a little bit more. And the angel told Zacharias that your prayers have been heard. Evidently, he'd been praying for a child. Evidently, he could have been praying for a son. Come on, somebody. Because a son came forth. And he told us that, listen, Zacharias, your prayers has been heard. Even though he heard the prayers of Zacharias. And when the Lord said it was going to come, he still didn't believe it. How many of us, we doubt God. In his reverence, in his presence, in his word. We don't want to believe what the word of God said. We want to alter it. We want to take this out. But it don't mean that God's word is line upon line. And preacher upon preacher. You cannot change or alter the word of God to reflect your life.
Preach that word.
Y'all better, y'all, you're like, woo, Jesus.
Better say it.
We always do that. But God didn't say I could do this. He didn't say for me to not do that. And we constantly doing the same thing over and over and over again. And we wonder why we're not growing in God. Oh, Ezekiel, can these dry bones live again? It's time for us to live in God and to walk in true holiness the way God had designed for us to be.
Amen.
Zechariah heard and he said everything. And then he said, and the Lord told him, you know, Zechariah, you're going to become dumb. I'm going to take away your speech until this thing happen. All because of what God has promised. People, we got to believe the word. If I put a title with this, believe the word and magnify who he is. Somebody better say amen.
Amen.
Zechariah, when they pulled him out, his eyes was open and he couldn't speak. And they said he must have seen a ghost or something. Something happened in there. Somebody better say amen.
Amen.
You need to believe.